Based on its considered assessment, the MPC voted unanimously to keep the policy rate unchanged. It, however, decided to continue with the accommodative stance as long as it is necessary to revive growth while ensuring that inflation remains within the target. The MPC noted that since its meeting in October 2019, global economic activity has remained subdued, though some signs of resilience are becoming visible. Turning to domestic developments, real GDP growth moderated to 4.5% year-on-year in Q2 1920, extending the sequential deceleration to the sixth consecutive quarter. The slowdown in GDP growth was cushioned by a jump in government final consumption expenditure. On the supply side, gross value-added GVA growth decelerated to 4.3% in Q2 1920, pulled down by contraction in manufacturing. Growth in the services sector moderated, but agricultural GVA growth increased marginally. Overall business sentiment remained in pessimism in Q3 1920. However, the Purchasing Managers Index for manufacturing increased from 50.6 in October to 51.2 in November 2019, driven up by an increase in new orders and output. High-frequency indicators suggest that service sector activity generally remained weak in October. However, foreign tourist arrivals posted improvement for the second consecutive month in October. Steel consumption also showed a modest revival on year-on-year basis in October 2019. There has been steady support to aggregate demand from union government expenditure in the month of October 2019. The PMI for services, which had remained in contraction in October at 49.2 due to a decline in new export business and turning down of business expectations, moved to expansion zone to 52.7 in November on a pickup in new businesses. As regards the external sector, exports contracted in September-October 2019, reflecting the persisting weakness in global trade. But non-oil export growth returned to positive territory in October after a gap of 2 months. Imports contracted faster than exports, and as a result, trade deficit narrowed in September-October 2019. On the financing side, net foreign direct investment rose to $20.9 billion in H1 of 1920, compared to $17 billion a year ago. Net foreign portfolio investment was of the order of $8.8 billion in April to November 2019, as against net outflow of $14.9 billion in the same period last year. Net investment by FPIs under the voluntary retention route have amounted to $6.3 billion since March 11, 2019. Net disbursals of external commercial borrowings, ECBs, rose to $11.5 billion during April-October 2019, as against $1.2 billion during the same period last year. India's foreign exchange reserves were at $451.7 billion on December 3, 2019, an increase of $38.8 billion over end March 2019. Consumer price inflation, that is CPI, increased sharply to 4.6% in October, propelled by a surge in food prices. Fuel group prices remained in deflation, while inflation in CPI, excluding food and fuel, moderated further from its level a month ago, reflecting the underlying weakness in domestic demand conditions. Taking into account these developments, the MPC revised the CPI inflation projection upwards to 5.1 to 4.7% in H2 of 1920 and 4 to 3.8% in H1 of 2021, with risks broadly balanced. Real GDP growth for 1920 is revised downwards from 6.1% in the October policy to 5%, that is 4.9 to 5.5% in H2 and 5.9 to 6.3% for H1 of 2021. In line with the slowdown in the economy, GST collections so far have fallen below the budgeted targets, and a similar scenario with regard to direct tax and customs duty collections cannot be ruled out. It is also likely that the government may initiate some more countercyclical fiscal and other measures to arrest the slowdown. The forthcoming union budget will provide greater clarity on all these aspects.